After two Category 5 hurricanes, the Virgin Islands National Guard is entering the restoration phase. This after approximately 1,900 National Guard members from 37 states and territories reported for duty in the Virgin Islands to save lives, prevent injuries, and protect property.
We were able to get troops out into the community in less than 2 hours because we were already bunkered down at our facilities and we started branching out.
For over a month, soldiers and airmen have witnessed the destruction left by Hurricanes Irma and Maria on three different Caribbean islands, the physical and the emotional.
We're overwhelmed. Example, my house. My house is damaged. I'm trying my best to hold up, be resilient.
It was also a time for the Guard to execute competencies and capabilities. Thousands of people received tarps for homes, non-perishables, and water from Guard members who manned points of distributions, who also made it a point to raise spirits.
We are all under one bridge, one umbrella, just assisting the St. John community.
But hurricane support efforts also included providing aerial ambulatory capabilities, communications, shelter, power generation, medical treatment, reconnaissance, and other capabilities. As the Virgin Islands National Guard celebrated its own monumental milestone, 44 years of service.
You know, attention to detail, technical expertise, and respect for each other's roles that we play as a team.
We had an opportunity for the community to see the Guard in action and understand why it's critical for the National Guard to be in every state and territory.
Moving forward, military, police, and logistic support will remain for some time.
We still don't have power, and the MP support, which is primarily security, we anticipate that's going to go a bit longer, only because until power is fully restored, or at least 85% restored, we're going to have to keep the security force in place.
This is also a time for reflection.
Nobody wishes upon this kind of a destruction, but it has been good for us. It gave us an opportunity to show our competency and our capabilities. We'll be able to go back to the drawing board and figure out what we did well, where we need to improve, and how best to even assist the Guard, because I think the Guard can look at our story as not only a good news story, but the way forward in terms of how we continue to do this and build upon it, because it is critical that the Guard is there. It's critical that we remain relevant, and we only have two shots at doing it. It's only going to be in domestic support when we're on the homeland, or when we go to war. So I am grateful for the experience. I'm very proud of my guardsmen, my local Virgin Islands guardsmen. They did a phenomenal job. I am grateful for the extended family, all the guardsmen that came in and just jumped right in. I mean, if it wasn't for the patches, nobody would know, because we were all representing the military and representing it well. So from that standpoint, I just want to say thank you to everybody that supported the Virgin Islands. And I invite folks back, because I'm looking at another 6 months that you wouldn't even know a hurricane hit. And in another year, we'll be back bigger and better. I'm excited about what's in store for the Virgin Islands. So thank you.